going to attract a crowd for you?
Well, you know, that's all part of being a champion. You know, I've done been through them all. What you have here in a champion is class. I've made this belt stand out and mean something. You got the Soul Brother number one. You got the man that's done paid the cost to be the boss. And you know, I've done whooped them all. I've done whooped Hacksaw Jim Duggan. I've done whooped the Junkyard Dog. That's the reason why I'm wearing this. And I recall a time back when I was very popular up on the wrestling charts when Jim Duggan claimed that he was the only hacksaw in town, and I had to go out there and show him just who the true hacksaw was. And I think you got a tape of that.
We got a film clip of March, the Battle of the Hacksaws, downtown New Orleans. And Butch, if you'll give us the commentary, let's watch that now. There they are. The people are in downtown New Orleans, Municipal Auditorium, a packed audience, overflow audience. And, of course, at this point, the people are all in your corner. They're cheering you, and they're not exactly.
One time they were on my side. And one time the people recognized class and recognized a prime athlete at the peak of his career. And now me and Jim Duggan here, we're getting ready to lock horns. He's ranting and raving, trying to psych me out just like he does in all of his matches, tries to make me think that he's so big and bad and tough and just can't be stopped. And we fixing to get it on right here.
Well, sparks are ready to fly with Hacksaw Duggan. And you've kind of compared Duggan and Dog together. Say both of them are first quarter men, that they have a tremendous burst of energy, but they don't have the endurance.
They don't have that fourth quarter endurance. Those boys was kind of lagging, you know, in the fourth quarter drills playing football. When I was up there at the top, I was up there in the lead, leading the pack. And now you see me jamming and whamming on Jim Duggan here. He's flying out, shooting everything he had at me. Right here, I've got him coming off them ropes, sailing. Boom, right there, that big soup bone in there.
You have a lot of depth and a lot of scope in your wrestling ability. You can fight as well as use tremendous wrestling moves, your agility. We can't take it away from you. You've got the athletic ability.
Well, you know, I've come up hard. You know, nothing come easy to me. I know when I got to go out there, I got to fight for every little thing I get and any kind of way that I can get it with a man of this caliber.
Well, this was a long, grueling match. Again, these are edited highlights of that match March 21st in the downtown Municipal Auditorium of the Battle of the Hacksaws, in which you did win that match and the right to carry the title of Hacksaw, Butch Reed.
Well, you know, Jim Duggan here, he's a tough man. You knock him down, he gets up. He's coming. He's staying right in your face all the time. And it takes a little bit of brains. It takes just a little bit more brains than I told the people that I have. I have more brains than the Junkyard Dog, more brains than Jim Duggan. And right now, Jim Duggan, he's lost. He don't know what's happening. He's all tied up in wrestling, which is something that he don't know nothing about.
Yeah, but he knows how to fight, and there he starts trying to chuck it to you again.
That's for sure. But I tell you what, you know, these soup bones here is hard to handle, Bill Watts. As you see, Jim Duggan right now is all dazed and don't know where he's at, and he's wrapped right back up into that arm bar. I'm trying to pull his arm out of socket right there. I'm trying to really put the pressure on him.
Well, certainly it seems like late in this grueling match that Duggan may be having a conditioning problem, and that certainly you seem to have hit your stride. You seem to be in that fourth quarter. But Duggan is a dangerous man. At any time, he can go with that heavyweight knockout, that home run punch.
That's true. You know, this man is known all over the country. He was a tough competitor. He was a tough football player, professional, just like myself.
Well, you caught him a shot there. You really tagged him.
That was a good roundhouse right there. And, you know, not too many people gets up from that. That's the reason why I admire this man.
Well, you're picking him up.
He will fight to the last. You got to really wear him down. You got to really take him to the outer limits to keep this man down on the mat.
Now, he powers out. He's got a fighting heart. Duggan never gives up. Harry Duggan using a little bit of ability from the football field that he wasn't noted for, a little punting ability.
He tried to kick a field goal on my head here, and now he's on me like white on rice. And I mean, when this man gets on top of you here, you've got to figure out something pretty quick to turn the tide around, because he will eat you alive. Here, he's got me down from an elbow here. I managed to...
That's that powerlifting ability where you got that power.
That, yeah. Now here in the turnbuckle, his quickness right here. He thought he had me right there what does he call it? He calls that thing...
Spear.
A spear. And he's used that and hurt a lot of people. And he almost done it to me right here. Now I'm winding up on him. I'm giving them double soup bones. And now he's up in
here. You body press that 285 pounds.
Right
here. That was tremendously impressive, and you slam him down hard.
Now, Jim Duggan, he is really hurt right here. You know, not too many people gets up from that body slam there. And surely right here with that slingshot right there, that'll surely put the icing on the cake. Right there, the people are going crazy. I was a very popular man that night. I showed everybody who the true Hacksaw was. And now Jim Duggan is running around here ranting and raving.
Well, now you've got the title to prove it. But, of course,
right,
Jim Duggan is a changed man also, and he's got the crowd behind him. And what difference does that momentum or does that enthusiasm add?
Let me tell you something, Bill Watts. I'm not trying to win no popularity contest. Like I told all you people before, all I'm doing is winning matches. And I don't care how I do it anymore. Junkyard Dog, you sold me down for that chump I just beat.
Well,
and I'm coming after
We'll be back right after these messages from Mid-South Wrestling.